I'm expected to find the inverse of this thing. So the first thing I want to do is find the determinant of A. So what I need to do is rewrite this. Negative 6, 1, 4, negative 2, 3, 5, 2, 0, negative 1, and then repeat the first column. And repeat the second column. And now, I'm going to multiply these on the diagonal. I'm going to multiply these on this diagonal. I'm going to multiply these on this diagonal. Negative 18 times negative 1 is 18. Negative 2 times 0 times 4 is 0. 2 times 1 is 2 times 5 is 10. And I add them up, and that equals 28. And now multiply them on this diagonal. This diagonal and this diagonal. 4 times 6 is 24. 5 times 0 times negative 6 is 0. Negative 1 times 1 times negative 2 is 2. Add these up. That's going to equal 26. 28 minus 26, this minus this, is 2. So the determinant of A equals 2. That's the first step. Second process for finding the inverse after you find the determinant. Well, we figured out that the determinant of this matrix A equals 2. So we're going to multiply it by 1/2 eventually. So what I need to do now is find determinants of quadrants. This is a little tricky. So I take these little two pieces of paper, and I cover up row 1 and column 1. I'm going to find a little determinant there. So let's figure out what that little determinant is. It's going to be negative 3 minus 0. And that will give me negative 3. Now I move this over, and I find that determinant. That's going to be negative 1 minus 0. That will give me negative 1. Then I slide this over, and I take the determinant of that little matrix. That will give me 5 minus 12. That's negative 7. Now I'm going to come back over here and reset. This time it's the first column and the second row. I'm going to find the determinant of that little baby matrix. So that's going to be 2 minus 10, which is negative 8. Then I'm going to slide it over. That's going to be negative 6 times negative 1. It's 6 minus 8, which is negative 2. And I slide it over. Now it's going to be negative 30 minus negative 8. Negative 30 minus negative 8, I believe. It's negative 30 plus 8, which is negative 22. final row. I'm going to reset it. It's going to be the first column, bottom row. Find this 0 minus 6. Move it over. 0 minus 2. Move it over. Negative 18 minus negative 2 is negative 16. Now I have to fix all these signs. So positive negative 3 is negative 3. Negative negative 1 is positive 1. Positive negative 7 is negative 7. Negative negative 8 is positive 8. Positive negative 2 is negative 2. Negative negative 22 is positive 22. Positive negative 6 is negative 6. Negative negative 2 is positive 2. Positive negative 16 is negative 16. Now I have to do a reflection across this diagonal. So I'm going to copy that diagonal down in a new matrix. Negative 3, negative 2, negative 16. Now I'm going to reflect that 8 and that 1. So the 8's going to go above there and the 1's going to go there. So the 1's going to go here and the 8's going to go there. Then I'm going to reflect the negative 6 and the negative 7. So the negative 7's going to go over here. And the negative 6 is going to go up there and replace that negative 7. One more reflection of the 2 and the 22. 22 is going to slide there and the 2 is going to slide up. 22 slides down. And the 2 slides up. Almost done. I have to multiply this whole thing by the original determinant under 1. So I'm going to multiply this whole thing by 1/2. 1/2 times negative 3. That equals a new matrix with negative 3/2. 1/2 of 8. That's going to equal 4. 1/2 of negative 6, that's going to equal negative 3. 1/2 of 1, that's going to be 1/2. 1/2 of negative 2, it's going to be negative 1. 1/2 of 2, it's going to be 1. 1/2 of negative 7, it's going to be negative 7/2. 1/2 of 22, it's going to be 1/6. And 1/2 of negative 16 is negative 8.